What's going on, YouTube? So you're here now. So let's get on with the video. So The Guilty, now streaming on Netflix, is a psychological suspense thriller. Jesus, that's so hard to say. Psychological suspense thriller starring none other than Mr. Jake Gyllenhaal himself, all you Gyllenhaalics out there. The movie follows Gyllenhaal. Well, they don't really follow him because he doesn't really go anyplace. So let me say this first. Mild spoilers for The Guilty. But the movie follows Gyllenhaal's character, whose name I don't really care to remember, through his shift as a 911 police dispatcher. Or I guess he's the 911 operator. He's the person who answers the calls when you call 911. But he's going through this job very haphazardly and very reluctantly, as he's been demoted from the detective or sergeant or whatever it was he was doing before he got this task. He was doing something else, got into some kind of trouble, and he was demoted to this job. So he's really, really, really not thrilled about being a
hello, this is 911
dispatcher. Quite frankly, it is evident that he stinks at this job. So that is the plot. Gyllenhaal sitting at his desk, answering 911 calls and sucking at it. And you don't really know where the movie is going, especially if you don't read the synopsis. And if you haven't watched the movie and you want to go in fresh, of course, don't watch this review because this is a mild spoiler review. I definitely say watch the movie, come back, watch the review and tell me what you thought of it. But the plot of the movie is very simple. Jake Gyllenhaal at his desk in a Castaway type performance where it's really just him. Yes, there are some other actors whose name you might know who are credited for roles in this movie, but I will just tell you up front, you will not see them in the movie. Ethan Hawke is credited as being a voice character, so is Peter Sarsgaard, but you will never see them in the movie, and their voices are not that recognizable. I don't think I would pick Ethan Hawke's voice out of a lineup, and I definitely wouldn't pick Peter Sarsgaard's voice out of a lineup, but they did give, I guess you would say, strong acting. No, I don't think they had much to work with, so I'm not even gonna say they gave strong acting performances. It was kind of like maybe Jake needed a favor from somebody and he called up his good buddy Ethan Hawke and said,
hey, you want to talk on the phone with me for a little bit for this movie role? It's gonna pay you something.
And they showed up and they did the movie. The movie was a very smartly budgeted film because they actually didn't go any place. The movie took place all in two rooms, and maybe more people will start making movies like this because Hollywood productions are not making as much money as they once did. So maybe somebody will decide, hey, let's just build a story around a room and do it like that. But the plot is simple. The cast is simple. It is Jake Gyllenhaal and the guy from the Discount Double Check commercials.
Discount Double Check.
Discount Double Check.
Discount Double Check.
So now you have the plot, and now you have the cast, and now you have the base, the filler of the movie. Not really a lot I can say about this film, other than it was suspenseful. It was acted well by Gyllenhaal. Even though he was the main and only guy, he did give a solid, strong performance. You did feel all of his emotion. You felt the tension. He did a good job in building up the tension because the movie was somewhat suspenseful. It did take you down the ride of what's going to happen next, and you find yourself waiting moment after moment after moment to see when the other shoe is going to drop. Like, what's going to happen next? All of this is happening, taking place in California during a major, massive, like one of those forest fires that they're having out there, unfortunately, all the time. So the movie, that's the backdrop of the movie. The backdrop of the movie is police force is kind of stretched thin dealing with the fires. So something is happening. He's feeling like he has to take control of the situation, and he's not getting help from the other powers that be. And everybody's basically telling him, listen, just shut up and do your job. It was a very interesting look into what a 911 dispatcher may go through. I hope things are not dealt with in the light that it was dealt with in this movie. So many people seem to not really care that much about the plight of human beings in danger or in need. Everybody had their ego in the way of, listen, you just do what you do, I'll just do what I do. People weren't moving fast enough to try to help with a cause or something that seemed dire. They thought that he was just barking up the wrong tree. He was trying to do too much, of course, because he used to be a police officer, and he's basically screaming to get from behind that microphone and actually take charge. And that's when you start to see some of the other layers of his character, you know, kind of be peeled off. You wonder what it is that happened. What was the catalyst event that led him to his possible suspension, or what has him in this legal trouble where he's talking about this court case that's coming up, or his court appearance that's coming up. You feel like, okay, was he a dirty cop? Did he take a bribe? Did he potentially kill somebody? Like, what happened that has him, you know, faced with doing this task, not being the regular police officer or regular detective that he was, and what is his fate going to be? But 40 minutes through the movie, I'm watching the movie and I said, wait a minute, we've been watching this movie for 40 minutes and nothing as of yet has happened. And you hate to have a movie. I hate going on that type of roller coaster where I'm kind of just waiting and waiting and waiting. And the movie has done a good job. You can't say the movie didn't do a good job if that's what they base the movie on. If that's what they were trying to do when they built and crafted and wrote this movie, they wanted to kind of suck you in and draw you down this rabbit hole and get you wondering and get you kind of on the edge of your seat to wonder what's going to happen next. And it just seemed like a lot of things weren't happening next. Now, some things were later revealed. Scenario, and again, this is a mild spoiler review. Of course, it was a scenario where he's trying to help this young woman who he believes has been abducted by her husband or her ex-husband, and he's trying to help her children be safe, and he's talking this girl through these phone calls. And a lot of things that was happening in the movie seemed kind of baffling to me, because I was like, wait, I was really suspicious. Like, if this girl's really been kidnapped, if she's really been kidnapped, why is her kidnapper allowing her to continue to talk on the phone? That was like a red flag that something wasn't as it seemed there. Now, mind you, I will say this. I did not see the twist that came later. I did not see that coming. I didn't really see that she was the one who was responsible for her child's death. I didn't see that coming at all.
Boy, that escalated quickly. I mean, that really got out of hand fast.
But I knew something was kind of weird there. Like, you know, what kidnapper would allow her to be talking on the phone? And then the fact that they had this long conversation, the kidnapper allowed her to continue to talk to her child. It was very odd, but it did help with the tension. It did help with the suspense. But the thing that infuriated me the most about the movie was the ineptitude of, or I don't know. It was watching how all of the characters surrounding the situation was handling or not handling the situation at hand. And even after the police reached the residence that he directed them to go to and found the child seemingly dead, they still didn't spring into action and take the situation seriously. It was still like him against the world and trying to find and help this lady. And I get that this is a movie. I get that it's fictional. I get that they were dealing with the fires and that was made apparent that the police force was stretched so thin. But that was aggravating. That was like over aggravating to just see everybody just not doing their job. And then in the end, I kept asking myself, who's the guilty? Like, what is the title of this movie about? Like, where do you come up with the title, The Guilty? And then in the end, you get it. It's kind of like everybody. Everybody's guilty. This woman that he was trying to help that we thought was the victim was not. The husband, in a sense, or the ex-husband, he definitely wasn't the perpetrator, but he really wasn't innocent either. He was guilty of a great many things himself. And then, of course, we know the other shoe drops and we hear the guilt confession of Gyllenhaal's character himself, and it's like he's guilty. And then, you know, another cop was basically gonna go lie for him on the stand, and it was so much of nothing. But I'm not gonna say it was a bad watch or I felt like I wasted my time watching it. So I'm gonna make this review very quick because the movie was quick, thankfully, and the music should start playing right now, hopefully, and I can take this silly thing off my head because I'm wearing this as a prop. And I really, like me, I applaud anybody who is doing that type of work and doing it well and actually caring about the well-being of the people that are actually calling 911 and have to sit there and wear one of these things all day, and to all the people that work at places like T-Mobile and State Farm. I don't know. But the gang has decided after further deliberation, and The Guilty, starring Jake Gyllenhaal and Jake Gyllenhaal, will get a solid 6.15 out of 10 on the Heartstorm Media Review scale. And only reason I'm giving it over a 6, because although not much happened in the movie, it didn't make me wait too long to find that out. The movie was only a solid hour and a half, so it's like watching two episodes of something on Netflix. So yeah, that's about right. Didn't take the time to look up who the director was. Maybe I'll put it in the clip notes here or put it in the description. If you want to see more videos like this, please like, share, and subscribe. Or just like and just subscribe. It doesn't cost you anything. And I make videos like this all the time. And hopefully my next one will be better. Well, actually, I know my next one will be better because I'll be watching a better movie. And I'm out. Hey guys, thanks for watching. As always, if you like these videos, you can click my face here to subscribe or here to watch more reviews.